All right, guys, some round two, and this hand's also unbeatable. All right, it's probably beatable, but it's a very good hand. So yeah, I'm gonna lead off with death right. If he chooses to kill it right away, then we can just play a darn confidant anyways. And I don't know. Regardless, I mean, we're going to Inquisition and then follow it up with Dark Confidant. I'm going to do this first in case he path to exiles, I guess, in response. All right, so it looks like the blue-white-red deck. I'm going to go ahead and take this Spell Snare. He does have a couple of ways to kill my Dark Confidant, so hopefully he doesn't draw a red source. He's got Bolt, Cryptic, Vendilion, Think Twice, and Helix. But since Snare just automatically counters one of my cards, I'd rather do that and just have him, make him draw the red source basically. Let's take the Spell Snare here. Let's go ahead and get a this is tricky. It's either green black or green red. Because if we get green black, that allows us to cast Liliana. Yeah, I'll go ahead and get green black. Like, we're pretty far away from the Chandra right now. So playing the Bob here, if he draws a land, he's probably going to go ahead and he if he draws a red source, he has to draw a red source. There's only 12 in the deck, I think. Oh, that's more than fine. We're gonna go ahead and get, I guess, a forest to activate more oozes. Yeah, okay. We didn't get exactly punished, but I forgot about Path to Exile. Because of Path to Exile, we should have maybe gotten a red source, because if he paths us, then we can do that. But we didn't get punished, so that's sweet. What do I want to do here? I kind of want my Tarmogoyfs to be like a little bit bigger. I want them to be able to survive the bolts and the helixes. So right now, a Tarmogoyf and a Scavenging Ooze, actually, there is no difference between the two. So I don't mind if the Scavenging Ooze dies. So I think I might want to just lead off with that. And I'm going to use the Death Rite to remove a Think Twice. Well, there's a Tectonic Edge. Look, so he's got a Vendilion click. I think he's gonna click himself, because he needs to draw lands, or not. He can also not. All right, so he took the Chandra, which I can't cast, which is more than fine. One too many Death Rite Shaman. So yeah, I'm just gonna bash in with the Zeus here. I don't mind the trade, because then our Tarmogoyf cannot die to his burn spells. All right, and now we are going to drop Tarmogoyf, and Bolt, Cryptic, Helix. I'm actually just gonna go ahead and drop another Death Rite Shaman here. He's pretty far away from Wrath Mana. There's a red source. I mean, he's probably just gonna kill a Death Rite Shaman here. Helix of Death Rite? Sure. It's fine. And let's go ahead and try to resolve the Tarmogoyf first to play around Mana Leak. And I'm just going to go ahead and attack a treetop. And if he wants to use a tectonic edge, that's also fine. Let's get a red source. I think black, red, we have more than enough green here. Oh, that was a punt. I did that incorrectly so many different ways. I should have left this untapped, or I could have gotten a green source. That was an oversight. Now this is very awkward. All right, now we're just gonna do that. Use this to make green. And activate treetop. Okay, so he killed it. I am not playing around Wrath, by the way. Generally, the decks that play the version with Vendilion Click sideboards Wrath of Gods. He might be playing Shahar's version with like cryptic commands and stuff. He's got Bolt. So he has cryptic command and something. Oh, that was a good draw. I'm gonna go ahead and take the cryptic here because that buys him time for my Goyfs. Like otherwise, my Goyfs are lethal next turn. And that should be the game. All right. One of the reasons why I think blue-white red is just not a great choice in the current metagame anymore is that the Cheon matchup is 50-50 at best. I think Cheon might have a slight edge here, and it six copies of it top eight at the last Grand Prix. So you might need the format to slow down a little bit before you decide on playing a blue-white red. Especially, when you're playing things like Think Twice and Snapcaster Mages and your opponents are packing, four Deathrite Shaman and Scavenging Ooze. It's not really the best way to go about it. So here, you definitely want Thoughtseize. Don't care about Gravedigger's Cage because we do have the Oozes and the Deathrite Shaman. Batterskull is actually pretty strong in the matchup. Let's see. Not too interested in Ancient Grudge, Pyroclasm, Shatterstorm, or Sowing Salt. It's a little slow. I mean, it's good against Colonnade. But we're going to bring in the Fulminator Mages because it's good against Colonnade. And I'm not sure about these. I got to figure out what cards I don't want. Like, I'm looking at Maelstrom Pulse. It does kill Planeswalkers if he does happen to play them. I think I like the Oozes just as kind of a beater slash counter to Snapcaster Mage. You don't want stuff like Ops and Battle. Olivia's actually fine because I know it can get bolted or whatever, but it does attack pretty well through the Restoration Angels that he could potentially be playing. I guess bolts are not great in this matchup. And we gotta cut one more card. I like all the hand disruption. I like the terminates. Perhaps it's just cut one Scavenging Ooze. I like the pulses just in case he had, like I said, he brings in like some number of Batterskulls or things like that. Sure, I can see cutting one Ooze. We have four Shaman as well, and it's not really gonna grow that much, probably. This could be wrong. This could be wrong, but I'll try it.